Hello students, in this lecture of halogen derivatives of alkanes and arenes, we are going to discuss about physical properties of haloalkanes and haloarenes. The first physical property that we are going to discuss is physical state and odor. Now, let's discuss about physical state. Haloalkanes like methyl chloride, methyl bromide, methyl fluoride and ethyl chloride, basically lower haloalkanes, are colorless gases at room temperature. The other haloalkanes, steel carbon number 18, are colorless sweet smelling liquids, while the higher members are colorless solids. In the case of haloarenes, they are generally colorless liquids with pleasant odor or crystalline solids with characteristic or peculiar smell. Now let's discuss about boiling point trends. For small alkyl group, that is when R is smaller, the boiling point trend for haloalkanes is alkyl iodides are greater than alkyl bromides, have greater boiling point than alkyl chlorides. This is because as the size of halogen increases, the surface area available for van der Waals forces to act increases, the molecules come closer and hence more energy will be needed to vaporize that compound. For the same halogen atom, the trend will be different. Let's switch to this next slide. Now in this case, what we are keeping the same? We are keeping the halogen atom same and we are changing R. So as the size of R increases, as the number of carbon atoms in alkyl group increases, again the surface area will increase. Again, more surface will be available for van der Waals forces to act. The magnitude of van der Waals force will increase, the molecules will come closer and hence the boiling point will rise. But in the case of isomeric haloalkanes, where R is the same, where R contains same number of carbons and halogen as well is the same. In such cases, boiling point will decrease with branching. This is because with branching, surface area decreases. Haloalkanes are polar in nature. The CX bond is polar. X carries delta minus charge, whereas carbon which is attached to X is delta plus. You already know this. And in alkane, CC bond is almost non-polar and CH bond is almost non-polar. So when we compare the boiling points of haloalkanes and alkanes, obviously haloalkanes are going to have greater boiling points than corresponding alkanes. In case of haloarenes, the boiling points and melting points are nearly same as that of haloalkanes containing the same number of carbon atoms. For the same halogen atom, boiling point and melting point increases as the size of aryl group increases. Now, let's take the case of boiling points of isomeric dihalobenzenes. Here, as you can see, that para isomer is more symmetrical. So the packing, better packing in crystal lattice will be obtained for para isomer. So obviously para isomer will have highest melting point as compared to ortho and meta isomer. And the boiling points will be nearly the same. Let's discuss solubility. Alkyl halides are polar, but still they are not able to form hydrogen bonds with water molecule. As a result, they are insoluble in water. However, they are soluble in organic solvents like ether, benzene, alcohol, chloroform, CCl4. Aryl halides are generally immiscible with water, but they are miscible in organic solvents like dissolves, like rule applies over here. Now let's focus on density. Alkyl chlorides are lighter than water, whereas bromides and iodides are heavier than water. The density follows the trend. Alkyl iodide is greater than alkyl bromide, which in turn is greater than alkyl chloride. Their densities increases with increase in number. Remember this, the densities of alkyl halide increases with increase in number and mass of halogen. We'll take few examples. Let's switch to the next slide. See, in the first example, you can observe as the number of chlorines in the molecule are increasing, the density is increasing. So, methylene dichloride is having least density, whereas carbon tetrachloride has highest density. In the next example, as we move from left to right, the size of halogen is increasing, that is the mass of halogen is increasing. As a result, its density is also increasing. For aryl halides, they are heavier than water and their densities follow the trend. Aryl iodides, obviously the one with the biggest halogen has highest density, then aryl bromide and then aryl chloride. Now let's discuss the next physical property, that is called as dipole moment. As you know that all the alkyl halides are polar, so they will have a certain amount of dipole moment, and obviously generally it is greater is the electronegativity difference between carbon and halogen, generally the dipole moment will be greater. A small anomalous behavior is observed in the case of methyl chloride and methyl fluoride. Here the small change is because of smaller size of fluorine atom. The value for dipole moment of methyl chloride is 1.86 debye, that of fluoride is 1.847 debye, for bromide it is 1.83 debye, and that for iodide is 1.636 debye. And for haloarenes, again the small anomalous case of fluorobenzene is again because of smaller size of fluorine. Bromobenzene and iodobenzenes nearly have similar dipole moments. Their value is around 1.70 debye, which is highest in haloarenes, followed by chlorobenzene, which has dipole moment of 1.69 debye, and fluorobenzene has least dipole moment in this category and it corresponds to 1.60 debye.